Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our fifth bout of the evening. It is our first ever Medicine Hat title fight! This School of Hard Knocks fight is an amateur bout in the 170-pound weight class and is brought to you by Ginger Kids Studios, our official photographer for School of Hard Knocks 17. And now, let's meet the fighters. He's fighting out of LaRonde, Saskatchewan. He is Todd Thompson.
Todd the Wolf Thompson coming down to the cage for our 170-pound amateur title fight from LaRonde, Saskatchewan with the LA Warriors MMA. He's been training for about a year, 3-0 in that year of training. Doing a solid job to open his amateur career is Todd Thompson. Taking a good look at the title belt, which is sitting here at our table, is Todd Thompson. His brother saying, that's what you're going for, that's what you're fighting for. And he said he wants to bring the belt back to LaRonde, Saskatchewan, where it would be an awfully big deal.
Yeah, you know, that title belt is huge. That's your credentials right there. I mean, you can win a ton of fights, but you know, those belts, jiu-jitsu belts, title belts, those are the type of things you need to kind of show yourself as a pro fighter. Like, when you go professional and you have amateur belts to your name, you know, people are a little more weary of you. Because a lot of people nowadays, they go pro way before they're prepared. But if you've got an amateur title under your belt, then it proves that you've been training, that you've been working hard as an amateur. You've built your way through the ranks and you're ready to be a pro.
Younger brother of Barrett Thompson, and he says he'll be glad to be bringing home a title belt before his older brother does. And Barrett Thompson with 10 fights in his career, unfortunately unable to fight tonight as his opponent was unable to make it here.
His opponent.
So now we get ready for Sugarless Riley Molyneux. Sugar, a fairly common MMA nickname.
Calgary, Alberta, this is Riley Molyneux.
Riley Molyneux coming down to the cage, of course, a type 1 diabetic, which is why the Sugarless moniker gets to cage side well in advance of his coaches. Took a run to get to cage side, eager to fight for this title, as he his 3-3 amateur, his last fight was a win, a first round armbar decision victory at Hard Knocks 15 in Regina, fighting after just a month, and says that he did his research on his opponent to help develop his game plan for tonight.
Yeah, you know, Riley's a very, very tough fighter. He's a competitor through and through. This kid begs his opponents to hit him. He wants to get in a slugfest. He doesn't want to go in and win in the first round. He wants to win by decision in a crazy, brutal fight, and you've got to love that.
And now for the official fighter introductions. In the onside restoration blue corner, he's 3-0 as an amateur, 23 years old, and stands 6 feet 1 inches tall. He weighed in at 169.6 pounds, fighting out of LA Warriors in LaRonde. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Todd Thompson! And in the Rouse Texas Bar and Steakhouse Red Corner, he's 3-3 as an amateur, 19 years old, and stands 5 feet 11 inches tall. He weighed in at 170.2 pounds, fighting out of Dynamic MMA from Calgary. Please welcome Hard Knocks fighter, Sugarless Riley Molyneux! This bout will be contested under amateur rules. The referee in charge of the Hard Knocks action is Elvis Lyon.
Gentlemen, fighters to the center of the cage. 5-round title fight, give it everything you got, keep it clean. If you're gonna touch gloves, touch it now, back to your corners.
Riley, work the body! Touch the body, Riley! Just remember, Riley, you got this!
Molino in the black and camo trunks, black trunks with white trim for Thompson. Both fighters touch gloves at the center of the cage. Molino throws a kick. Thompson tries to catch it, but is unsuccessful. Another leg kick early from Molino.
Yeah, Thompson's looking for that takedown early. He kept his hands low, and it backfired.
Big throw from Molino to end up on top of Thompson, as he has done very well from this position in his Hard Knocks fights. Working up against the cage, Thompson is backed up. Riley in a dominant position.
You know, Riley's comfortable here. He wrestles with the UFC Dinos. Something you're going to see a lot in this fight is him maintaining position on the ground.
Riley doing a good job so far on top of Thompson as Molino looks to increase his position and try and land some strikes. So far, not much going. You do see a couple shots to the body there. Thompson trying to work a guillotine choke, has the head of Molino trapped, although now he's lost it. Molino works to the other side. A very effective guard here from Thompson on the ground, though, keeping Molino spread out with his legs, also keeping a good job of keeping Molino's head down and his arms locked up.
Yeah, Molino's fighting with that wide wrestler's base, so he seems pretty comfortable. He's definitely not leaving himself susceptible to sweeps.
A couple more punches on the ground there into the face of Thompson from Molino. Again, the 170-pound amateur title on the line here. So should this fight need to, it can go 5 3-minute rounds.
You know, both these fighters look conditioned for those 5 3-minute rounds.
Looks like Elvis Lyon going to stand him up. A good job on the bottom for Thompson. Unable to do any damage from the top was Molino, and able to lock him up. Thompson was stopped there and threw a couple punches with bad intentions, one of them landing.
Yeah, Thompson needs to get his hands up because Molino has very good boss.
Oh! Big kick to the face from Thompson. From Molino, rather. He's swarming. Thompson seems to have recovered on the ground. Hammer fist now from Molino. Thompson holding on and able to roll Molino over, and now is in a side control position. A nice recovery from Thompson after a big kick to the head. Good sweep there from Molino to return to a standing position. Knees coming from both fighters to the midsection. This title fight is picked up.
Yeah, both these fighters are getting comfortable and they're really starting to let their hands go. This next round should be a beauty.
10 seconds left now or less in round number one. A foot stomp attempted by Thompson. The second one lands. Guillotine choke from Molino to end round number one. And what a performance here in the title fight. A big kick from Riley Molino, the best of the round. And to his credit, Todd the Wolf Thompson doing a very good job of recovering there and getting into a dominant position, albeit briefly. I think if you're judging it on the scorecards, Molino's going to come out with a 10-9, but a close one and a good round from Todd Thompson.
You know, Todd Thompson took that head kick like a champ. Most people would have stayed down, but, you know, that's why he's in that title fight. He took that shot, he battled back, and, you know, seasoned veterans, that's the way they do it. They can take shots like that, and they can keep coming at you.
And full credit to referee Elvis Lyon allowing Thompson to get the second to recover, which allowed him the time to recover, because you may have thought immediately upon that head kick hitting, I thought that a knockout was possible from the way Thompson went limp momentarily. Doors are closed, fighters are ready. Round number two here in our co-amateur main event, as Riley Molino in the black and camo goes head to head with Todd Thompson in the black with white trim. Thompson now has Molino up against the cage, tries to throw a knee but doesn't find anything. Riley handing him a couple of punches, but not much damage coming from those punches to the face. Knee coming from Thompson. Another knee to the thigh of Molino from Thompson, working to really damage that power base, which he was able to use so effectively in round number one.
Yeah, Thompson's landing a lot of knees to the inside of the legs, and those are definitely going to show some wear and tear later on in this round.
And Molyneux has had trouble with his knees in the past. He says that they're fully healed now 100%, but he has had damage to those knees before.
You know, Thompson's really grappling up against the cage right now, but he cannot leave his head down like that because he's going to leave himself open to a big knee from Molyneux, and Molyneux can get a little distance between the two.
More foot stomps from Thompson. You can see they hurt as Molyneux's face went into a bit of a grimace. A nice takedown there from Molyneux, dropping over, throwing his opponent over, and now ending up in Thompson's guard.
That's Thompson. That wrestling base right there. He's extremely strong, and you can pull off things like that when you train with the UFC Dinos.
Thompson, very effective in his guard in the first round, was able to limit Molyneux to the point where the referee stood them up. Molyneux continuing to try and pressure forward, though, on Thompson and move forward in this position. Needs to posture up to get a couple strikes, does throw a knee. Again, you hear his coaches in the background telling him to forget the knees and just pass his guard, and that's proving to be a harder task than is called for from the coaches. Thompson again from the bottom seems content to hold Molyneux down and just prevent damage again, maybe hoping for a stand-up.
Yeah, Molyneux's worked hard to get into this position. I'd really like to see him step over with his left leg and begin to mount his opponent. When he gets into the mount there, he's going to be a lot more effective with his ground and pound.
Good hooks on the guard, though. You can see Thompson's foot wrapped around the shin of Molyneux, which really prevents him from getting out and passing. He may have an opportunity there on the left-hand side, but now doesn't take it, and he sees that a couple more punches landing to the midsection of Thompson.
Yeah, Thompson's doing a very good job of holding him in his guard right now. Molyneux has been trying to escape, but, you know, he can't seem to find anything. And there he goes for that leg.
Tries to grab the leg again, just 10 seconds left. And Thompson now into Molyneux's guard, but unable to do any damage before the end of the round. Round number two in the books. Again, five rounds if necessary in this title fight as both these fighters continue to go at it. Molyneux taking a big gulp of water there in the corner, as does Thompson, as they get set for round number three here in the title fight action. Again, the first ever 170-pound amateur title for the Hard Knocks Fighting Championship. And you can expect to see a lot of titles coming out of the Hard Knocks Fighting Championship and all their weight classes as they start to roll out their title belts and establish their championship stable. And one of these two men in the cage tonight will be walking out of here a champion. Molyneux, just 19 years old. Already this his seventh amateur fight. Thompson on the other side at 23, and again 3-0 undefeated as an amateur. So Elvis Lyon, our referee, checking to make sure that the cage doors are closed and set before we start round number three between Riley Molyneux in the black and camo and Todd Thompson in the black with white trim.
Molyneux is extremely comfortable with his boxing, and he's going to unload some big shots if he can get in on his opponent.
Thompson tries the front kick, does not connect. Trying again with the high kick is Molyneux. He gets those kicks up in a hurry, trying to hold him at bay with a front kick. A couple punches from Molyneux landed, but Thompson again recovers quickly.
Yeah, Thompson's really telegraphing his strikes right now, and Molyneux doesn't seem to have any problem with his standing. He's throwing big looping hooks, and he's not landing anything because he's showing that punch from a mile away.
Now, you got to think that hitting Riley Molyneux's knees was part of the game plan for Todd Thompson, as even in the center of the cage, the knee-on-knee contact is where he wants to go. Molyneux tried to roll over with a submission attempt, but was unable to do so, and Thompson now ends up on top. Riley with the big power move to sweep his opponent, and now ends up on top. Does Molyneux, a huge press, just effectively picked Thompson up and flipped him over.
Yeah, Mulano's an extremely powerful 170. I mean, this guy could easily be fighting at 185 and be comfortable there. But, you know, today I was hanging out with him in the hot tub, and he told me he was already back up to 180 pounds.
Mulano, again, trying to work from the top. Hasn't been as effective as he has in the past from this position, and, of course, that credits Thompson's guard.
Yeah, Thompson's done pretty much everything right from the guard position, but he isn't sweeping his opponent, and he's not doing anything from the bottom. No submission attempts and no effective striking.
Thompson approves from the half guard to the full guard, and again, you can see Mulano spread those legs out, get that wide power base before he drops some shots to prevent the sweep and prevent Thompson from getting out of this position.
Yeah, Mulano should just sit here in his guard and grind away with punches and elbows, because that's what's winning him the rounds.
He tries to pass, throws the legs over, and is now into side control, able to land a punch through, and now drives a knee into the midsection of Thompson. Again, another undefended punch to the front of Thompson's face. And Mulano, again, trying to work side control, now working the ground and pound, giving him the forearm shiver as he goes by. And again, continuing to pound down on Thompson and ride him a couple hammer fists now to the side of the head. Mulano doing a very effective job here in side mount as he works towards trying a submission attempt on the other side. He's got Thompson's arm isolated, but unable to finish that off. And again, with 10 seconds left in the round, Riley Mulano on top of Todd Thompson here in round number three. So that is the end of the third round as Riley Mulano and Todd Thompson look to get to the championship rounds. Round number four upcoming, and you can see the title belt there being paraded around the cage, never been worn, and it's going to be around the waist of a champion in 6 minutes or less here at Hard Knocks 17 in Medicine Hat from the Cypress Center.
If Todd Thompson wants to be wearing that strap at the end of the night, he's going to need to finish Riley Mulano, because Riley is definitely winning the fights 3-0.
So far, so good for Riley Mulano in his corner. Todd Thompson getting advice from older brother Barrett Thompson in his corner. Again, 90 seconds between rounds here for the amateurs. Riley Mulano screaming, "Let's go," from his corner. He is ready to fight. Todd Thompson ready to answer the bell as well. Championship rounds coming up right now here as the door gets closed on round number four between Thompson and sugarless Riley Mulano. Again, touching gloves at the center of the cage, and they are ready to go. A leg kick sets up a nice right hand from Mulano as Thompson thought about shooting.
Yeah, Thompson doesn't like the power that Mulano possesses right now. Every shot he's hitting him with, he's cringing.
And precise strikes from Mulano. Thompson lands a big left of his own, though, swinging over top. And Riley takes that one face forward, but he just keeps on coming.
Yeah, if Thompson doesn't get his hands up, Riley Mulano is going to land another head kick soon.
A head kick coming from Thompson, but missed. And Mulano comes in, big strikes coming the other way from Thompson. He's throwing big punches now, looking for the knockout as Todd Thompson decides to wrap up and throws a knee to the midsection of Mulano.
Yeah, this is an exciting fight. Both these fighters are leaving it all out there. You gotta love that.
Ooh. Another head kick from Mulano to Thompson, who takes it without even flinching, and they go up against the cage, and Mulano secures the takedown. Mulano on top of Thompson, starting to drop punches. A timeout has been called by the official, and it looks like I'm trying to figure out why the time was called. Oh, it looks like something was stuck in the cage, it says Hard Knock CEO Ari Tobe, a sharper eye than ours from here, but restarted in a mount position. Riley Mulano continues to work from the top as he looks to continue winning rounds here in the championship fight with Todd Thompson. Another knee comes from Mulano to Thompson. A warning issued there quickly Not sure to which fighter. Just saw the words warning come from Elvis Lyons' lips. Warning about an elbow. Not sure who landed it from this position. But Riley Molyneux continues to fire punches down. And he is doing very well from this position, as he has done throughout the fight thus far.
Yeah, you know, Molyneux just needs to keep going with what he's doing right now because it's working. He's sitting in that guard. He's landing strikes. He's moving forward. And his opponent isn't doing anything down there. And that's why he's up 3-0 and about to be up 4-0.
So far, so good for Riley Molyneux in round number 4 as he continues to work and land punches to the body as well as to the head of Todd Thompson, who has been on his back for about the last minute or so with not much in the way of defense, but able to keep it defending well enough, to, of course, to prevent a stoppage. But just 10 seconds left in round number 4, and Riley Molyneux continuing to damage from the top as he's doing very well in his first title fight. Round number 4 is now in the books, and we get set for the 5th and final round here in our 170-pound amateur title fight. Again, not often we get to see round number 5 here in the Hard Knocks Fighting Championship. I believe this is the first one I've ever seen in the Hard Knocks Fighting Championship. The first fight to go into the 5th round here. The first title fight to potentially go the distance as Riley Molyneux gets some last minute coaching for round number 5. Good big smiles on his face. Just looked at his coach and said, yeah, I'm good. And on the other side of the cage, Barrett Thompson giving Todd Thompson some advice, telling him how to defend those takedowns, how to get in and strike. But if you're on Jordan Murray's scorecard, I believe that at this point he's got to be talking finishing this fight, because if he's not able to finish Riley Molyneux here in the 5th and final round, that, if again, by Jordan Murray's scorecard, we'll see a decision victory for Riley Molyneux.
And I am by no means an official judge.
No.
So just take it for what it is.
No, and nor have we seen official judges match up with our opinions here at the table before. So this could be, I would suggest this is a close fight anyway. 5th and final round. Touching gloves for the 5th and final time. At center is Riley Molyneux in the black and camo. Thompson in the black and white. Thompson tries the head kick, does not connect. Molyneux gets back. That one did get through, although mostly blocked from Thompson.
You know, Molyneux's throwing that lead head kick, and it's landing every time. You got to think that's due to Thompson dropping his hands and trying to sucker Molyneux in to strike with him.
Big leg kick, which sets up another head kick attempt, but Thompson able to block that one.
But he doesn't look like he's enjoying it. He doesn't look like he has an answer. He's throwing into the legs, and then he's throwing to the head, and everything is landing.
Molyneux drops another couple of fists. Thompson backs up. Discretion being the better part of valor, as it has not worked out well for him when he's ended up in a clinch with Molyneux thus far.
You know, Molyneux, when we talked earlier, this is exactly what he wanted. He wanted a 5-round fight. He wanted to slug it out. For him to win the title tonight is going to be the icing on the cake, because this is the fight that he's been looking for his entire career.
Molyneux continuing to pace forward, seemingly content to stay back and land strikes. A big punch there, more punches to the midsection as Thompson felt that punch to the face. Molyneux now takes his opponent's back, and you can look, he's looking for the arm bar in that position, and Thompson able to work that into a dominant position in Molyneux's guard. Surprise move to go for the arm bar from that position, but that has been his go-to submission.
Yeah, you know, Molyneux's not going to just try to win on points. He's going to try to finish this fight any way he can.
So far, Thompson not doing much damage from the dominant position here. Molyneux with good wrist control tries to throw up a triangle, and so far unable to hook it in too deeply is Molyneux as he tries to get his leg up over the, as he tries to get his knee up over his ankle, is unable to do so. Tried maybe to pull for the armbar there, but able to pass now is Todd Thompson.
You know, in the 5th round of this fight, these fighters are both very slippery right now. But I've noticed that Thompson, some of his hand wrap is coming off, and you got to wonder if the ref's going to see that and stop the fight. just to get that hand wrap fixed.
Pulls the arm out, tries to finish again, putting pressure on the shoulder and elbow joints of Thompson as he rolls that knee over, twisting the shoulder and elbow of Thompson, pulling that in, trying to do it. Thompson, very game, his face in pain, but
there
refusing to tap. And that's the end of the fight. Riley Molyneux is your 170-pound amateur champion with a fifth-round submission as Todd Thompson taps, and Riley Molyneux gets himself a title belt.
Yeah, like I said, Molyneux would try to finish this fight if it was in the first or the fifth round. And that's the heart of a champion right there. You know, he was up four rounds to none, and he still finished the fight in the fifth.
Ladies and gentlemen, while we wait for the official decision, Hard Knocks would like to thank Ken Goldaid and D&D Oilfield Services for transporting the Hard Knocks cage all over Western Canada this fall. Your support of local sports in Medicine Hat is appreciated by Hard Knocks, as well as the entire Medicine Hat community. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the official decision brought to you by Ginger Kid Studios. The winner by verbal tap out at 2:44 in the fifth round, in the red corner, Sugarless Riley Molyneux!
Riley, what's got you here in the center of the cage? How good does that title belt feel around your waist right now?
I'm worried about the fight. That was a lot more fun. I like the belt, though. It's nice.
Now, you said this morning that you were hoping for a five-round fight, that you wanted to go as far as you can, get into those championship rounds. A heck of a performance.
Yeah, I wanted to get the experience of being in here for so long, and he held with me every step of the way, so it was a fun fight.
Walk us through the finish.
We were really slippery in guard, and he was trying to land some shots and stuff. And once he committed to that shoulder, I just slid out, and I had the Omo in, and he held on to the last second, and now she's history.
So now that you got a title belt, fans are going to be able to get their picture with you wearing the title belt at the after party, right?
Absolutely. I might be a little intoxicated. I apologize in advance, but...
Now, your coaches here in the corner, they obviously helped you get here today. Talk about your club and your coaches.
Dynamics of family. Everybody comes out. Everybody comes out and supports. RJ there, Devin Kirk, best wrestling coach in the world. Vince puts it all together, manages us all. It's a family. If you're not training there, you're not training at the best place.
One more time for your 170-pound amateur champion, Riley Molyneux.
That's right, trigger between my eyes, please strike, make it quick now, wait, I'm coming undone, I'm ready, I'm coming undone, too late, I'm coming undone, what looks so strong, so delicate, wait. is lighter than a feather. Looks like I'm not getting better, not getting better.